Adriana is taking her first nap. I am just watching her on the monitor. Hopefully she sleeps good because she is super tired. I think her back molars are coming in or just a back tooth because she's been having a lot of redness like inside this part. And I did take her to her pediatrician about a week ago for the same thing because she keeps putting her fingers inside of her ears and just kind of rubbing at it and tugging at her ears. So I'm like, okay, does she have an ear infection? So I took her into the pediatrician and they said that usually ear infections are not red around the ear canal, but it's actually the ear drum. And the only way that you can tell if it's an ear infection is if somebody looks inside with a light, a doctor or a pediatrician, or if you have one, I think they're called an ostoscope. I'm probably completely wrong right now, but it's something like that. The little tool that goes inside the ear and looks inside there. That's the only way that you can really tell if a child or somebody has an ear infection because it's the ear drum. So they said that she didn't have an ear infection last week when I took her in to check out the redness. And they said that it's potential teething. And that teething can cause redness in the ear canal. And this also is from her putting her finger in it and obviously her like bothering it, and she keeps touching her ear and that's causing the redness. And she most likely has a tooth coming in somewhere in the back. So she's kind of thinking it's her ear because it's in the back of her mouth, but it's nothing to do with her ear. It's just kind of related to her tooth hurting. So I'm hoping that she gets a good nap because she has been pretty fussy all day, and I think it is because of the tooth or whatever it's growing in. So hopefully she takes a good nap. She did go down about a half an hour ago, so we're going strong right now. At least 2 hours would be wonderful because I know that she needs it, and this is probably gonna be her only nap of the day, so the longer, the better. I just washed all of her bottles, and I actually introduced this sippy cup yesterday. It's by Tommy Tippy because she does use the Tommy Tippy bottles, and this is what the lid looks like. So I do really like this for a sippy cup for her to use. It is a non-spill, so when I like dump it out, it's completely like dried, nothing comes out. But I always try things that I give her first, and I did try to like suck the water out that I gave her, and it actually is really hard to get water out of this sippy cup. So I also tried the Munchkin sippy cup that has the handle. You turn this and it has like a little straw. This is also really hard to get the water out. So I have no idea if just all sippy cups, I don't remember. I didn't know that it was that hard to get water out of sippy cups. But, I mean, the Tommy Tippy one, I'm hoping that she'll like and adjust to because they're very cute for one. The other one has a unicorn on it. But, I mean, I figured since she uses a Tommy Tippy bottle, maybe she used the Tommy Tippy sippy cup. If not, I did try this Munchkin one too, and she rejected both of them. She ended up just chewing on both of the tops instead of trying to get water out. And I think she actually did try to get, like, pour it, you know, in her mouth. But it was so hard for her to cut, like, the water to come out that I don't think she was really understanding that you, like, have to suck it really hard to get the water out. So I'm hoping that I just keep introducing both of these and eventually she'll take one. But if you guys have any better recommendations for sippy cups and good transition cups from a bottle to a sippy, then let me know down below because I really need some good suggestions. These are the only two that I've tried and she's pretty much rejected both. But I know that they're not going to be taking a sippy cup right away. All babies are different. I didn't expect her just to start sucking out of the sippy cup and be an expert at it because she's been using bottles this entire time. But I do want to start showing her different ones because she is almost 10 months, and at the 12 month mark is when we really got to cut down on the formula. So with that being said, let me know any suggestions that you guys have used for your kids in transitioning to sippy cups because I could really use them. And I'm going to Target today or possibly Walmart, so I could definitely pick some up. So I am gonna make some lunch right now and also create a list for the store because we need to get some food in this house and stop being lazy, and we need to go to the store. So I'm gonna write a little list down and have some lunch. When you see your baby waking up and then she puts her head back down, is she gonna wake up? Her eyes are open. Is she waking up? Oh, she is waking up. Let's go get her. Let's go get the little snookums. Hi, sweetie. It's Mama. How are you doing? Are you still sleepy, honey? It's okay, babe. Somebody woke up really hungry and had some Happy Baby Organics raspberry oats and banana. She's over here making a huge mess, but that's okay. Her pediatrician actually recommended that you let babies explore with spoons, so she hasn't gotten the concept of the actual spoon side yet, but she loves chewing on the end of the spoon, so she actually ate the entire jar, so that is awesome. She's doing really good on baby food. I actually think she's kind of transitioning herself with more foods and wanting less formula and wanting to try different foods. So that's really good because I was a little bit worried about, you know, certain transitions from formula to mainly just eating regular foods and just sippy cup transitions and things like that. I've just been a little bit nervous about. But so far, she's actually doing really well, and she's eating a lot of baby foods. We give her peas, we give her corn, things that we could put on her high chair and kind of just let her eat finger foods and just cut things up into really small pieces. We let her eat little noodles. I just cook plain whole grain noodles and just cut those up for her. Now she's ready to get out. She wanted out of the high chair. No, I honestly think it's like her teeth, or she hasn't gone poop today, so she could be a little bit constipated. But she's been really fussy for the majority of the day, just kind of like yelling like that. And she's never fussy, so it's kind of not like her. She's definitely not acting like herself today at all. But, oh, you see your toy, that's exciting. She's also going through leap number 9, so that's probably another reason why she could potentially be fussy, because they are the 3 C's: crying, clingy, and I forget the last one, but I know that there's like, they call it the 3 C's, and they tend to be a lot more fussy and just not like themselves, and she is in a leap, so that kind of explains different things too. She's in leap number 9, and it's a really long one too. I still follow the app pretty well. And it's crazy because when she is in a leap, it's just insane how like different she is. So I do listen to it because I notice the difference, and it's definitely real. This is what's happening right now. Baby crackers on the ground, and you're probably stepping on them. What's going on? You're acting so weird today. You're not yourself. And she's just running them over. That's exactly why I have a baby vacuum. Yes, I know. I have to vacuum them. Comes in handy for things like that. It happens quite often with those baby crackers, but she loves them. You guys see this baby right now? She's like on her knees trying to stand on her 3-in-1. She was so fussy, I had to turn her show on. She was like throwing a huge tantrum, and there was nothing that was working, so I figured I would just let her watch a little bit of her show. She hasn't watched her show all day, so I thought, why not let her watch it for a little while before we go to Target, and we also are having a pizza night, so you seem a lot happier now, which is good, but it was short-lived, so hopefully she continues to be on this happy streak. She loves the camera. Hi! What are you doing? Wow, good balancing skills. Wow. I know. You want your bottle? Which I thought that's why she was so fussy, because she wanted a bottle after she ate her food. I gave her like some crackers and the entire baby food, the raspberry and oats, and thought it was the bottle, but she barely even drank the bottle. So it has to be like her teeth or something, because she's never fussy, and we really don't even give her the show that much, but when she doesn't feel good, I'm just like, whatever, let her watch the show. We all have those days where we don't feel good and we just want to lay and lounge around and watch TV, right? So I kind of put her in that same category. I am super pumped because I think I'm about to go on a little shopping spree at Bath & Body Works because today they are having a little sale and they have all of their fall candles right now, you guys. I am so excited. Those flippin' email notifications are going to make me broke because they send me all of these like Bath & Body Works stuff on my email, and then when they of course tell me that fall stuff is gonna be here, I mean, how can I resist? So here is all of the fall stuff, you guys. Yes! Leaves. I'm so pumped for leaves. And then they have some new ones too. And today they're buy two, get two free. So it says the two lowest prices are free. Whatever. So I definitely am going to get a leaves. And the cider one, apple cinnamon cider, smells really good too. And plus PJ likes that scent, so he's definitely an apple person. I need to turn down her TV. This one actually smells really good. Also, this one's my all-time favorite. I'm not a fan of the cinnamon pumpkin. And then this one PJ absolutely hates, so I won't do that to him. Caramel apple is good, and this is new. Pumpkin, so I don't know if I should get that since I haven't actually smelt it. Caramel apple, I mean, it smells like what it says. And then Perfect Autumn, I've never smelled that one, but it sounds like it smells good, so I might risk it and get that one too. And then two free ones, I might just go with my usual and get Sweater Weather because I love that one. And where's the other one? I don't know if, I like Autumn as well. So I might do Sweater Weather, Autumn, and then Leaves and that new one, the Perfect Autumn. But I have not decided. And then they also have a $10 off 30 coupon. You type in Hello Fall and then $10 off 30, and that just gives you even more of a discount, which is amazing. And I also need to get more wallflower plugs, which I'm sure that since they came out with the candles, they have wallflower plugins of fall stuff too. So, oh, these are cute. Oh my gosh, I love this one. How cute is that? And it's a nightlight. I love the nightlight ones. It's a little more expensive. It's $16.50 versus the $12.50 ones. Actually, you know what? They're all different prices, just depending on the design. And then the basic ones are $12.50. But I would definitely, I usually do pay the extra when getting a nightlight one just because I do like the nightlights the best. I actually have one that I just plugged in over in the kids' play area. It has like little butterflies on it, and I haven't used it, but I think it's the only one that I actually didn't get that's a nightlight, and I thought it was a nightlight, but it looks like this. Well, it's hard to see, but there's just like little pink butterflies on it, and I just plugged in a new one. I haven't decided. Luckily, if you don't like the little wall plugins or if they stop working, a little tip I've known about for a while. I think I shared it a long time ago with you guys, but for my new subscribers, if you don't like your wallflower plug, the actual thing, or if it stops working, because that's normal, they do stop working after a certain amount of time, like the scent won't come out as strong as it was when you first plugged it in. You can just take it back to Bath & Body Works and exchange it for a brand new one that was in the same price range as the one that you just gave back. And you just get a brand new one for free. You just give them your ID. You give them back the old one that doesn't work anymore or the one that you just don't really like and switch it out for like the new ones. This baby is crazy. She keeps grabbing on to that little black table where we have the TV. And she's trying to stand herself up. Makes me so nervous. So we have one of those little corner protectors. But still, like, I need something for the front of that table because literally makes me a nervous wreck. PJ just got home with the pizza. And Adriana is actually way better. I don't know if this is TMI, but she went poop and now she acts like a completely different child. So she is not fussy anymore. Ooh, and she is so much better.
Fussy with a bowl, I know, but, of poo inside. Like,
no, but she was.
Don't you feel better when she you was, release?
Yeah, because she was. Did you just toot?
I just released. I feel better. See how it works?
Ew.
Try it sometime.
Damn. No, thanks. No, but all day she was super fussy.
You're talking
I thought
camera.
It was her tooth. And I think it was because she didn't go poop all day. Now she went poop and she's acting totally fine. So when babies don't go poop, that can be another reason why they act completely different and not themselves.
I want to buy a new pot and pan set soon. Those are disgusting.
I like those pots and pans.
You don't want to buy those pots and pans?
I just really like them.
It's time for a new, well, we can go get a new Rachel Ray set. That's what it is.
She just dropped her bottle.
Dude.
So we got pizza. We're having a pizza tonight. So this is called, what's it called again?
It's called the Cowboy.
The Cowboy.
It's pretty much pepperoni, I'm sausage, olives, four types of cheeses, and some sprinkle seasoning on it, which is really good. Comes with mushrooms, but
we don't get mushrooms.
I'm not a mushroom guy.
Yeah, I don't like mushrooms either. I hear you bouncing. She went through a phase where she was not bouncing at all, but now. Whoa! That is amazing. Hi, sweetie. Are you ready to get out? We're at Target. Ooh, nice and cold. What are you doing? I found this cute top that I'm gonna get. Target always sucks me in for cute tops. That's PJ's face about the cute new top. We came to Target for a little random trip and we are completely out of baby food for her. We only have the pouches and I don't like giving her those at home. So I get her these jars from the Happy Baby that I was talking about in my last vlog. Sorry. And this Target actually just got remodeled, so it has a lot of selection, more than it did before. So I'm gonna get a couple of the pouches and then probably a couple of these too. They don't actually have a lot of the ones that she likes, surprisingly. Uh-oh, somebody's not happy. Oh no. These are cute. They do not have her size, of course. Me rolling, they hating, patrolling and trying to catch me riding dirty. 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 My music's so loud, I'm swinging. They hoping that they don't catch me riding dirty. That is going to be it for this vlog. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, leave me a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more. Also, turn those bell notifications on so you guys will be notified when I do upload on my next video. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.